ipagpapatuloy natin yung driving test in Japan 2022. Nasa question number 36 na tayo, kaya ano pang hinihintay natin? Hi guys, this is Alan. Welcome back to this channel, Gaijin World. Pero bago yan, kung hindi nyo pa napanood yung mga previous questions neto, ayan, puntahan ninyo doon sa description box ng video na to para masundan ninyo. Okay, so let's proceed. Problem number 36. Okay, problem number 36. This sign indicates no vehicle crossing. Okay, so ito yung problem number 36. So this sign indicates no vehicle crossing. So itong figure na yan, wala raw pwedeng dumaan dyan. Okay, no vehicle crossing. Is it true or false? I think the answer here is false. Kasi yung sign na yan indicates no U-turn. Yun ang tingin ko, no U-turn. So I think this is false. Check na natin kung tama ba ang sagot ko in 3, 2, 1. Ayan. So, ang sagot ay incorrect or false. Okay, kasi nga, yan o, new, ano yan eh, U-turn yan eh, no U-turn. Pa-letter U. Okay, problem 37. You may not park within 3 meters of a parking lot or garage doorway, but you may park within 3 meters of a garage doorway at home. Nako, medyo nakalimutan ko na to. Pero about ito sa distance ng parking area kung saan ka pwede mag-park. So according dito sa question ay hindi ka pwedeng mag-park within 3 meters of a parking lot or a garage doorway. But you may park within 3 meters of a garage doorway at home. Medyo mahirap yung question para sa akin, kaya manghuhula ako. Eh, sana tama ang sagot niyo dito. So, I think ang sagot dito ay false. So, let's see. Let's see if the problem 37 is false. Ayan, false nga guys. False ang sagot. Nanghula lang ako. Maganda dyan guys, puntahan niyo yung book. Kasi may mga... yung mga related sa parking lot, yung mga distance, kung gaano kalayo, saan ka magpa-park, ando dun sa book na Master in Driving Skills ba ata yung title. So yun guys, let's proceed to the next question. Okay, problem 38. Since the water in the radiator is used to cool the engine, there is no need to check or refill the radiator during the winter months when the temperature is lower. So, ulitin ko, since the water in the radiator is used to cool the engine, there is no need to check or refill the radiator during the winter months when the temperature is lower. Nako, parang hindi ko to ginagawa kahit netong mga nakaraang buwan. During winter, hindi ko yata to nagawa. Hindi ko na-check yung radiator niya kung may tubig. Mukhang delikado yun ha. Pero I think this is false. Let's see if the answer to problem 38 is false. The radiator water is meant to cool the engine, so there is no need to inspect or refill it during the colder winter months. I think this is false. Yes, the answer here is false. Ayan, false guys. Kasi parang dapat talaga nire-refill, chine-check eh. Kasi lalo na kung winter eh, baka naman tumigas na yung tubig. Naging yelo na. Let's proceed to problem 39. When traffic is light, you may drive only for your own convenience as you will not be bothering other pedestrians or cars. Kung medyo hindi naman ganun ka-heavy daw ang traffic, you may drive only for your own convenience as you will not be bothering other pedestrians or cars. Pag sinabi mong your own convenience, edi kung gusto mong pagpatakbo ng mabilis, okay lang. So I think the problem here ay yung for your own convenience. I think hindi ka dapat mag-drive for your own convenience. Lagi kang mag-check kung may pedestrians at lagi kang maging precaution, lagi kang mag-exercise ng precautionary, tama ba? Para avoid accidents na involve yung pedestrians and cars. Ayan. So, let's see. I think the answer here is false. So, problem 39. When the traffic is light, it does not bother other pedestrians or cars, so you may drive only for your own convenience. The answer, I think the answer here is false, so let's see. Yes, it is false guys. So, yun yung keyword do. Okay, yung convenience, for your own convenience, I think that is wrong. Okay, problem number 40. Motorized bicycles turning right at an intersection marked with this sign must approach the center of the road in advance and slow down just inside the center of the intersection. Okay, let's check yung sinasabi niyang sign. A motorized bicycle that makes a right turn at an intersection with this sign must approach the center of the road in advance and drive slowly just inside the center of the intersection. Ah, kasi nga motorized bicycle to eh. Genske, kung merong ganyan, okay, so merong bawal mag parang two-way, mag ABC, parang A point going to point B, then going to point C. So kung merong ganitong sign, ang gagawin pala ay mag-approach ka sa gitna ng road and drive slowly just inside the center of the intersection. Is it true or false? I think the answer here is true. Let's see. Yes, it's true. Ayan. So parang yung katulad lang din sa mga cars na kapag hindi pa sila pwedeng mag-right turn dahil nga yung mga pa-upcoming pa lang yung pwedeng tumawid, pwede na siya lang mag-advance dun sa gitna ng intersection at maghintay ng kanilang turn para makaliko. Okay, problem number 41. Cars are prohibited from overtaking cars and motorized bicycles near the top of an uphill slope or on a steep downhill. Okay, ulitin ko. Cars are prohibited from overtaking cars and motorized bicycles near the top of an uphill slope or on a steep downhill slope. I think ito kasi yung top of an uphill, 'di ba? Kapag nag-overtake ka doon sa pataas, eh, hindi mo naman pa nakikita kung may kasalubong ka. So I think that is wrong. Okay? So I mean, yun nga, wrong nga na mag-overtake ka. Kaya nga sabi dito, cars are prohibited from overtaking cars. So, I think the answer for this problem is true. Okay, kasi mali nga naman na mag-overtake ka during paakyat yung uphill slope. Ang hindi ako sure dito, yung or on a steep downhill slope. Okay, so, nag-guess lang ako. I think this is true. And let's see if the answer here is true. Problem number 41, cars are prohibited from overtaking cars and motorized bicycle near the top of an uphill or on a steep downhill slope. Is it true? Yes, it is true. It is true. The correct answer is true. Okay, let's move on to the next question. Problem number 42. Driving behavior is a repetitive process of recognition, prediction, judgment, and operation. And to prevent traffic accidents, it is necessary to always try to anticipate danger. Ayan. Driving behavior is a repetitive process of recognition, prediction, judgment, and operation. Tatlo yan, guys. Tatlo. Yan pala yung pinakaunang-unang question yan dun sa book na dapat mong tandaan. Prediction, judgment, operation, and to prevent traffic accident, it is necessary to always try to anticipate danger. So, I think the answer here is true. So, let's see. Problem 42. Driving behavior of a car is repetition of cognition, prediction, judgment, and operation. In order to prevent a traffic accident, it is necessary to always try to drive in anticipation of danger. True. Yes, that is true. Yan. So, tandaan nyo yan, guys. Ha? Laging lumalabas yan sa Karimen. And I think sa Honmen lalabas din. Okay, let's proceed to problem 43. Even if there is a no stop sign in front of a police station or fire station, it is a sign for emergencies and it is okay to stop at the sign if it is not an emergency. Okay, so tingnan natin, mukhang may ano to eh, may picture to eh. Problem number 43. Pero I think the answer here, nung binabasa ko na siya, I think the answer here is false. Kasi kapag bawal kang huminto sa harapan ng police station or fire station. So problem number 43, even if, ayan, guys, even if a stop prohibited part is marked in front of a police station or fire station, it is an emergency sign, so it is okay to stop at the sign except in an emergency. So emergency man o hindi, dapat di ka mag-stop dyan. So it is, the answer I think here is false. So yeah, wala pala siyang picture. So false, guys, false. Tama ang sagot is false. Question number 44. When driving a car in a group, you must not drive in such a way as to impede traffic around you. So I think this is true. So let's see. I think the answer here is true. Number 44. When driving a car and driving in a group, do not drive in a way that obstructs the surrounding traffic by translating. Mali yung translation. Pero I think this is true. Yes, the answer here is true. Answer is true. So let's proceed. Okay, problem 45. When making a left turn, except at a traffic circle, the time to signal is when you start to turn the wheel. Mag-subscribe na rin kayo at hit the notification bell para lagi kang updated sa mga susunod ko pang i-upload ng mga driving exam lessons. Ayan. So sabayan nyo kung mag-answer ng mga question either true or false lang, guys. Ayan. So meron din ako mga nakakalimutan, di rin ako palaging tama, kaya ayan, panoorin nyo, guys. So i-check nyo rin yung aming mga playlist, kasi kung ikaw ay may planong pumunta dito sa Japan bilang student or working in working related visa, ayan, panoorin mo ang aming mga videos na nasa aming mga playlist, kasi marami kang matututunan dyan. Okay. When making a left turn, except at a traffic circle, the time to signal is when you start to turn the wheel. I think this is false. Kasi kapag magsisignal ka, dapat bago ka pa lang maglumiko. Parang, nakalimutan ko. Anyway, hindi yung sa mismong corner ka na magsisignal. Dapat bago pa lang, okay? Siguro mga nakalimutan ko, guys, comment down below nga ninyo kung saan kayo magandang magsignal. Kasi pag, ang naalala ko, pag nagdadrive ako, paliko, bago pa lang nagsisignal na ako. So, tingnan natin. So, the answer here, I think, is false. Ayan. The time, ayan, guys, the time to signal when making a left turn except at a roundabout is when you start turning the steering wheel. I think this is false. Oh, di ba? False nga, guys. False. The answer for problem 45 is false. So ayan, guys, I hope nagustuhan nyo tong video na to at marami kayong natutunan sa video na to. Kung nagustuhan ninyo, please like this video and mag-comment na rin kayo. I-share nyo na rin to sa mga nag-aaral ng driving dito sa Japan para makapasa sa kanilang Karimen or Honmen exam. Ayan. So maraming salamat sa panonood at sana makatulong yan sa inyo. Okay, and ito din, itong mga video na lalabas dito, i-check nyo rin yan at malamang makakatulong din yan sa inyo.